Right, now with metric to imperial conversions, there are a number of equivalences that they expect you to know, and they are on the revision page of the website under metric imperial conversions. And unfortunately, you've just got to learn them. Sometimes, as you'll see in this question, they give you them, but they can quite often expect you to know what those equivalences are. Okay, so this first question is to do with the maximum weight limit of luggage getting onto a plane. This particular airline, the maximum weight limit is 20 kilograms. A passenger has luggage weighing 18 kilograms and he wishes to add an item weighing 1200 grams to his luggage. So, in order to find out whether or not this is over or under the 20 kilogram limit, we need to add these two values together. But we can't do that when one's in kilograms and the other's in grams. Well, one of the things you need to know is that there are 1,000 grams in a kilogram, so 1,200 grams. We can turn that into kilograms by dividing by 1,000, which would be 1.2 kilograms. Now I can add those two together. Eighteen plus 1.2 is 19.2 kilograms. So the limit is 20 kilograms. So he is okay. He's under that, and we can work out how much under it he is. So he is 20 minus 19.2, 0.8 kilograms under the limit. Okay, 0.8 kilograms or 800 grams if you're working in grams. You could have changed the 18 kilograms into 18,000 grams and added on and work entirely in grams. Now, the second part of the question is now comparing metric units, kilograms and grams, to imperial units, which are in pounds. LB is short for pounds. So it's helping us here. It's telling us that 1 kilogram is approximately 2.2 pounds. So just like exchange rates, if you've been working on exchange rates, we can write this as a number machine. To turn kilograms into pounds, we multiply by 2.2. So in order to make this comparison now, what I need to do is to take that 20 kilogram limit and turn it into pounds. Which is 44 pounds. So the 20 kilogram limit in imperial measure is the same as 44 pounds. So Anton's luggage weighs 50 pounds, it's over the limit. Right, so quite a difficult question. That's worth 8 marks, but you need to be quite confident in changing grams into kilograms, kilograms into grams, and kilograms into pounds to get those marks. The second question is an equivalence again. This is one they're not giving you, and you are expected to know, and that's the relationship between miles per hour and kilometers per hour. And what you're expected to know by the exam board is that 5 miles is approximately, is roughly the same as 8 kilometers. So for every 5 miles you travel, you've gone 8 kilometers. So if you're traveling at 5 miles per hour, you would be traveling at 8 kilometers per hour. And what that means now is that we have to turn 5 miles into 70 miles. And the way that we do that is by multiplying by 70 divided by 5, 14. Okay, if we take 5 miles, multiply it by 14, we get 70. So that means if we do exactly the same with kilometers, it will give us what we need there. So if we do 8 times 14, we get 112 kilometers. So if it's 70 miles, it's 112 kilometers. So 70 mph, miles per hour, is about 112 kilometers per hour. Okay, so again, if you don't recall that equivalence, you cannot access that question. And question 3, again with this one, they aren't giving you the relationship between kilograms and pounds. It's one of the ones they expect you to know. We met it in a previous question, that 1 kilogram is roughly 2.2 pounds. Pounds is LB. So 3.8 kilos times 2.2 equals 8.36 pounds. Now with the second part, they are giving you a relationship. They're telling you that 1.75 pints is roughly equal to 1 liter. So as a number machine, if we got liters on this side and we multiply them by 1.75, we get pints. A container holds 56 pints of paraffin, so we're starting there and we want to turn it into liters, so we're going backwards like we did with exchange rates. So we're going to take 56 and divide by 1.75. Two liters. Question 4. Darren claims that 6 pounds of potatoes is heavier than 3 kilograms of sugar. So again, what we're doing here is comparing pounds and kilograms. So this is our relationship here. So our number machine pounds. So if we take our 3 kilograms and turn it into pounds, that'll be 6.6 pounds, which is heavier than 6 pounds. So 3 kilograms of sugar, because it weighs 6.6 pounds, is heavier. So Darren is wrong. And Mary pours 3 pints of milk into a jug, which is volume 2 liters. So here we are having to recall the relationship between pints and liters. As you can see, a different question in a different year, they actually give you that. So liters multiplied by 1.75 will give you pints. So 3 pints, in order to turn the pints into liters, we need to go backwards through here. So 3 pints, turn that into liters, will be 3 divided by 1.75. Is 1.71 liters, which is less than 2 liters, so the jug won't overflow. Okay, two more questions that we need to take a look at here. Question five. Slightly different, this one, in that first of all it's a volume question. So what we've got here is a tank in the shape of a cuboid. I'll just draw a little diagram underneath just to help with the explanation. And we know that the base of this tank measures 62 centimeters that way and 35 centimeters that way, and we want to know what the depth of the tank is. Okay, so there's our depth. Now we know that in order to work out the volume of a cuboid, it would be length times width times height. So 62 times 35 times that height or depth there would give us the volume, and we know that the volume is 56,000 centimeters. So the volume would be length times width times depth in this case. So 56,000 would be 62 times 35 times D. So what we're forming here is an equation. And we can work out what 62 times 35 is. So in order to get the D on its own, which is what we want to find, I have to undo the times 2170. The opposite of timesing by that value would be to divide by that value. So D would be 56,000 divided by 2170. So 25.8 centimeters of water. Okay, so we just round that off to one decimal place. So that didn't have anything to do with conversions. It's the second part that does. Now there's two stages to this. First of all, it's telling us that 1 gallon is equivalent to 4.54 liters, but we haven't been given the amount of water in the tank in liters. We've been giving it in cubic centimeters. So the first thing that you need to remember is that 1,000 cubic centimeters is the same as 1 liter. So 56,000 centimeters will be the same as 56 liters. So there are 56 liters in the tank. They're telling me here that gallons, if I multiply that by 4.54, that turns it into litres. So I need gallons, so I've got to go backwards through my number machine. So I've got to take my 56 litres, divide them by 4.54, and that'll give me the number of gallons in the tank. So 56 divided by 4.54, 12.3 gallons. So again, a different slant on these conversions. And the final question where we've got these conversions is to do with a recipe. So we're given the ingredients to make enough mixed berry yogurt shake for 8 people. And the units that we're given here are in ounces, cups, and tablespoons. In this section here, they're telling us that we're told that 1 cup is 250 milliliters, 4 ounces is 115 grams, and 1 tablespoon is 15 milliliters. So the recipe is exactly the same. We're still doing it for 8 people, so we don't have to scale the recipe up, just change the units. So working with the cups, first of all, we got here that 1 cup is 250 mil, so 4 cups would be 4 lots of 250 mil. So if we do 4 times 250 there. We've got 1,000 millilitres of semi-skimmed milk. Exactly the same for the yogurt. Now, for the summer fruits, we need to change ounces into grams. And they're telling us here that 4 ounces is approximately 115 grams. So if 4 ounces is 115, I need 16 ounces. So I need 4 lots of 4 ounces. So I'm going to be doing 4 lots of 115 to get that, which is 460 grams of that. And for the honey, 4 tablespoons, it's saying that 1 tablespoon is 15 mil, so I need 4 lots of 15, which is 60 milliliters of honey. And then finally, Jamie has large quantities of natural yogurt, mixed summer fruits and honey, but only has 5.5 liters of semi-skimmed milk. Find the largest number of people for whom Jamie can make mixed berry yogurt shakes. So the milk required is in 1,000 liter blocks. So, sorry, 1,000 milliliter blocks. So 5.5 liters, if we change that into milliliters, then you'll see that that is 5,500 milliliters. He needs 1,000 milliliters for 8 people. So if we divide that by 1,000, we get 5.5 batches of the shake. Okay, he's got enough milk for 5.5 batches, and each batch serves 8 people. Okay, so 5.5 times 8 so he can make enough yogurt for 44 people. Okay, just clear that again. 1,000 millilitres he needs of semi-skimmed milk for every batch he makes. He's got 5,500 millilitres, so he can make 5.5 batches of the shake. Every batch he makes serves 8 people. So 5.5 lots of 8 comes to the 44 people.